Every single day we've been in here, except the first few, we have had a bill to raise the penalties on a crime that already exists. We just got to stop doing it. And the economic argument's very, very wise. We are spending a fortune on corrections. We're being ruined by the amounts of money we spend on corrections as crisis response, when we ought to be spending that same amount of money on prevention.
Cost of incarceration, but you know, we pass legislation and penalties for two reasons: to be used as a deterrent. If it's high enough, it can be a deterrent. Hopefully, you know, people won't do that behavior. But you know, most likely addicts, they're going to do it anyway because they're addicted. They make those bad decisions because they do have an addiction. But you know, for instances like this, I think that, you know, parents need to be held responsible.
Folks aren't thinking in the long term. They're not thinking about the penalty. They're thinking about what's right in front of them. And while I wish this bill, this legislation, would put an end to these stories that we're hearing, I'm afraid that it will not. What it will do is put a lot more people who could possibly benefit from treatment. It's going to give them longer sentences, not allow them to parole.
Talk about the cost of incarceration, but you know, we pass legislation and penalties for two reasons: to be used as a deterrent. If it's high enough, it can be a deterrent. Hopefully, you know, people won't do that behavior. But you know, most likely addicts, they're going to do it anyway because they're addicted. They make those bad decisions because they do have an addiction. But you know, for instances like this, I think that, you know, parents need to be held responsible for endangering their children.